Going to discuss detail about the embolism and hemorrhage. In this video we will detail discuss about few important definitions as well as definition of the embolus and embolism and what are the effects and causes of the hemorrhage as well as the classification of the embolism. Content of the class, important definitions, embolism, hemorrhage as well as classification of embolism. Before going detail into the topic, we will discuss few definitions. Hematoma, extravasation of blood into the tissues with resultant swelling is known as hematoma. Ecchymosis, it is large extravasations of blood into skin and mucous membranes are called ecchymosis. Purpuras are small areas of hemorrhages which is up to 1 cm into the skin and mucous membrane. Petechiae, these are minute pinheaded sized hemorrhages. Diaperthesis, these are microscopic escape of erythrocytes into loose tissues, may occur following marked congestion and is known as diaperthesis. Coming to the embolism, it is the process of partial or complete obstruction of some of the part of the cardiovascular system by any mass which is carried in the circulation, whereas embolus is the intravascular mass which is detached from its site of origin is called as embolus. Classification of emboli, broadly based upon 4 types depending upon the matter in the emboli, depending upon whether it is infected or not, and depends upon the source of the emboli and flow of the blood. Mainly 4 characters, like what is the matter in the emboli and whether the it is infected or not, and depend upon the source of the emboli and flow of blood. Depending upon the matter in the emboli, it is solid, liquid and gaseous. Solid such as detached thrombi, atheromatous material, tumor cell clumps, tissue fragments, parasites, bacterial clumps, foreign bodies. Coming to the liquid, such as fat globules, amniotic fluid, bone marrow, whereas gaseous, air and other gases. Depending upon whether it is infected or not, it is bland and septic. Bland when it is sterile, septic when it is infected. Depending upon the source of the emboli, it is cardiac emboli, arterial emboli, venous emboli and lymphatic emboli can also occur. Cardiac emboli such as from left side of the heart, example emboli originating from atrium and atrial appendages, infract in the left ventricle, vegetations of endocarditis. Coming to arterial emboli, examples in systemic arteries in the brain, spleen, kidney and intestine. Venous emboli, example in pulmonary arteries. Depending upon the flow of blood, it is 2 types, paradoxical embolus, retrograde embolus. Frequently in examinations these 2 questions were asked. Paradoxical embolus, it is an embolus which is carried from the venous side of circulation to the arterial side. Venous side of circulation to the arterial side, or vice versa, means like arterial side to the venous side, is called as paradoxical or crossed embolus. Example, arteriovenous shunts in the lungs. Coming to retrograde embolus, it is an embolus which travels against the flow of blood, is called retrograde embolus. Examples: metastatic deposits in the spine from carcinoma prostate. We will revise within 1 second. Depending upon the matter, it is solid, liquid, gaseous. Depending upon infection, it is septic and banned. Depending upon the source, it is cardiac, arterial, venous, lymphatic. But depending upon the blood flow, it is paradoxical and retrograde. The types of embolism are pulmonary embolism, which common origin is veins of lower legs, systemic embolism, common origin is left ventricle, fat embolism, which originates from the trauma to the bones of soft tissues, air embolism, which may be from venous, where from head and neck operations, obstetrical trauma, in arterial, it is cardiothoracic surgery, angiography. Decompression sickness, common origins descent, drivers ascent, unpursued flight. Amniotic fluid embolism, common origin such as components of amniotic fluid. Aterosclerosis, common origin is aterosclerotic plaques. Tumor embolism, common origin is tumor fragments. Arterial thromboembolism. In heart, it is most common. Examples of mural thrombi, left atrium and left ventricle, vegetative mural endocarditis, valvular endocarditis, prosthetic heart wall, cardiomyopathy. In lungs, it may be seen in pulmonary veins. Come to systemic, aortic atherosclerosis, carotid atherosclerosis, aortic aneurysm. In venous thromboembolism, systemic, it is deep vein thrombosis, which is most common in pelvic veins and in cavernosinus. Heart, right side of the heart. In lungs, pulmonary artery. Coming to the hemorrhage. Hemorrhage causes, it may cause due to trauma to the vessel wall. Examples, penetrating wound in the heart. It may cause due to spontaneous hemorrhage. Example, rupture of an aneurysm or septicemia. Inflammatory lesions of the vessel wall. Examples, bleeding from chronic peptic ulcer or typhoid ulcer. Neoplastic invasions. Example, hemorrhage following vascular invasion in carcinoma of the tongue. Vascular disease. Example, atherosclerosis. Effects of the hemorrhage. The effect of blood loss depending upon three main factors. They are the amount of blood loss, the speed of blood loss, the site of hemorrhage. The three main factors are amount of blood loss, speed of blood loss, and the site of hemorrhage. The questions which may asked in the examinations from this topic are: state any three causes of hemorrhage, state any three effects of hemorrhage, define ecchymosis, define purpuras, define petechiae, define embolism, define embolus. Classify embolus based upon matter in emboli. Classify emboli based upon source of emboli. Classify based on flow of blood. Explain retrograde embolus with example. Explain paradoxical embolus with example. It's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire.